We're tired of the devil pressing us down. Come on, y'all. Come on, it's time to fight.
What's happening, family? It's time to pray. And in our evening time, we've got one central focus, one thrust that we want to continue to drive in the hearts and minds of believers and those that are continuing to pursue God with all their heart. And that notion, very simply, is don't stop praying. Don't stop praying. We've been looking at Genesis chapter 32, verses 1 through 12, primarily, but also the entire chapter. I'm maintaining that this context, this chapter 32, is a picture of Jacob that ought to resonate with our heart because it shows the beautiful blessing of wrestling with God through prayer. The imagery of wrestling takes place in a number of episodes in the text. We've read verses 1 through 12 in our prior studies. I want you to think about the fact that in that notion of wrestling, remember the premise that you're wrestling with God in the seasons and situations of life are the occasions where you and I are most vulnerable, most intimate, and most dependent on the Creator. We've been looking at the fact that in every stage of Jacob's life, every stage of the portraits of him wrestling with God, we've seen him do it. We've seen him go to God and reminder of the connection of covenant and reminder of his descendancy and reminder of God's covenant power and presence. And now we're able to look a little deeper at a picture of Jacob in verses 24 and following. I want to read the first part of the text, but believe it or not, we're going to camp out at verse number 24. I just want to look at the first few verses, 24 through 26. The Bible there says, then Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When he saw that he could not or had not prevailed against him, he touched the socket of his thigh. So the socket of Jacob's thigh was dislocated while he wrestled with him. Then he said, let me go, for the dawn is breaking. But he said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. Beautiful text. But look again at verse number 24, and particularly the very first clause. Then Jacob was left alone. This passage, if you remember the storyline, Jacob had already felt the fear of facing Esau. He'd already gone through that trepidation. He talked to God in prayer. He then divided up his company, sent them on their way, and every individual, every group was going their way. And as they were going across to meet up with Esau and meet up with being received by Esau's people, Jacob stays back and Jacob is left alone. And this text, I really want to look at that first part and grab a thought out of that to remind us of why we should never stop praying. This text reminds us of the many layers and dimensions of wrestling that take place in the human condition. We often wrestle emotionally, psychologically, mentally, spiritually. And it's within those hand-to-hand close encounters that we find the depth and, in many cases, the limitations of our ability to progress. Jacob was alone, the text says. Reminded of all the things that Jacob may have been feeling in this period of being alone. He was dealing with fear. He was dealing with the fact that his family is on his mind. He had faith struggles. We know that, hence him going to God and telling God, I'm afraid. He was worried about his future. He's thinking probably back over the history of how he has failed. And there may be a myriad of other factors that are going on in Jacob's mind. But Jacob was alone, the text says. The wrestling took place while he was alone. And many times what you got to remember is that it's in those periods where you and I are thinking about all of what life dumps on you, all of what happens in life, that we find ourselves in some of the deepest wrestling moments in our life. Remember that God will allow for life to happen in such a way where the creature returns to the Creator for counsel on how to navigate in the nuisance of life that we call the human condition. Jacob was alone. He was wrestling, and wrestling is a one-on-one encounter. Generally, however, the worst type of wrestling is not necessarily when you are encountering a competitor outside of yourself. It's when you are wrestling within yourself. Jacob was alone. Can you imagine what it would be like? I want you to and answer the question, have you ever had an issue that you didn't have the words for, that you don't have the solution in mind, that you don't have the physical means of overcoming? Have you ever felt that kind of feeling in the pit of your person, that misery that messes with you? It hurts you. It messes up how your food tastes. It messes with your peace. It messes with your attitude. Messes with your joy. It messes up your reasoning. Have you ever had that deep sense of agony and hurt that's inarticulate? You ain't even got the words to describe what's going on. And that feeling within you, if you've ever felt that pain, then you know that the greatest challenge in your wrestling moments are not necessarily you wrestling with somebody else. You wrestling with the person in front of you. When you wrestle, sometimes the greatest bouts in you wrestling is whether or not you can overcome you. The real question is, in your wrestling, you might know you can defeat a competitor. You might look at the person across from you and think to yourself, I can take them, I can handle that. But can you defeat you? Especially when you know all of your moves, you know all of your strategies, you know your weaknesses, you know your maneuvers, you know your social tendencies, you know how to gain advantage. The text says Jacob was alone. Wrestling with God oftentimes is an event in which we are inviting God to be a part of the greatest bout that we've got to deal with on a daily basis. And that greatest bout that we deal with on a daily basis is not somebody outside of you. Believe it or not, it's not the enemy that you call in your mind. It's not somebody that you see, not your neighbor, not your coworker, not somebody in your family. The greatest bout that you got to wrestle with on an everyday basis, that you face when you open your eyes, that you deal with when you lay down to go to sleep, that's in your mind whispering to you, that's in your heart asking you things that don't make no sense, the person that you got to wrestle with and try to bring in submission or bring out a blessing out of, is not another individual. The greatest wrestling match is, can you defeat you? Jacob was alone. And you've got to remember some things about aloneness that can be a blessing to you, and also aloneness that can become a problem for you. You and I need to remember that God does some amazing things in the picture of us being alone. But we also got to be careful that the wrestling match about in being alone comes in a way where if you're not careful and cognizant of what God can do, you will allow that occasion to win over you rather than you getting the blessing out of the bout. Number one, let me share some things about aloneness. Number one, aloneness is a habitat for the heart's trickery. No one can whisper to you the diabolical equation or the diabolical formula to cause you to give up your faith like your own spirit. You know you better than anybody else, and your heart and your mind has the means of convincing you of doing what is unthinkable, doing what is ungodly, doing what is unconventional. Why? Because your words, your spirit, your mentality knows the code to cause you to fail. So that wrestling match has to be one in which you tell your flesh, you tell your spirit, you tell your heart, you tell your mind, absolutely no. I'm trusting the mind, trusting the heart, trusting the agenda of God in opposition to who I am. Remember that the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Jeremiah 17 and verse number 9. Number one, remember, aloneness is a habitat for the heart's trickery. So be careful about your wrestling with aloneness. But then number two, aloneness is a habitat for hurtful behavior. The Bible teaches us that it's when we are alone, when we allow those occasions where we're all by ourselves, that we end up doing things that are unpleasing to God. We end up doing things that give room for the idea. The text says in Proverbs chapter 18, he who separates himself seeks his own desires. Verse number one, he quarrels against all sound wisdom. Notice something that creating that space for hurtful behavior comes in isolation, which is why in the moments of being alone, you got to make sure you invite God there so that you don't have the final say over your behavior. Jacob was alone. And in that wrestling picture that we see with God, we are inviting God in those moments to be a part of the greatest bout that we deal with on a daily basis. And that greatest bout that we deal with on a daily basis is us. Let me give you number three. Aloneness is a habitat for holy becoming. See, remember some things about what happens when you are alone and as you invite God in. Number one, it actually is a misnomer, because for the disciple, if your mind is right and you are attuned to the biblical worldview, then you know that you're never actually alone. Even when you're wrestling with yourself. Now, here's the thing about your God that you want to remember. God will not be where he's not welcome. He will not force himself on you. He's not going to take over you. The Holy Spirit doesn't take over you. The Holy Spirit takes up residence. He's got to be invited in. He's got to be ushered in. You give him the seat. You give him permission. You move out the driver's seat. You let God take the wheel as it is. But you've got to give God permission to have his say. He wants to walk with you, and he invites you to walk with him, and he wants you to invite him to walk with you. Hear Jesus. Matthew 28, all power in heaven and earth has been given to me. Go make disciples of all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Teach them to observe all things, whatever I've commanded you. And look at the end of the text. And lo, I am with you. God's with you. Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus is always with you. Hebrews chapter 13. You remember that text describes that, why in the world would I be afraid of any man? What can man do to me? God said he will never leave me. He'll never forsake me. He's with me. I'm inviting that God to be with me. He said to Joshua, Joshua chapter 1, go back and read it, 1 through 9. I will be with you like I was with Moses. I will be your strength. I will be your resolve. God makes a promise to the believer that in that moment of being alone, it becomes a habitat for holy becoming when you and I remember that we're never actually alone. God can meet you. God can minister to you. God can make you into something more than what you believe that you actually are. He will make you better than how he's actually found you when you bring him in. Jacob was alone. And remember that sometimes our greatest wrestling bouts take place when we are in isolation, which is why we invite God to be a part of the wrestling with the greatest nemesis that we face, ourselves, and ask him to help us overcome the heart's trickery, to overcome hurtful behavior, to take up residence so that we can have a holy becoming as he goes with us. Jacob was alone. You and I wrestle many times alone, but God has the means of giving us a holy becoming. Can we talk to him? Father, we love you. We thank you and we bless you for being our God. We praise you for your power of helping us to become even more than where we are. Thank you, Father, for your strength, your mercy, the way that you continue to minister to us, the blessing that you've given us, Lord God, in becoming more and more like you through our encounters with you. We ask, Father, that you strengthen us and give us the means and the power of becoming even more than what we are. Father, we pray even right now that you bless us to be your people in the context that we're in. You know some of us are wrestling right now with fears and wrestling with our faith, wrestling with issues, factors beyond factors that continue to plague our life. God, rise up in our spirit. Help us to know and sense that you are there. Help us to appreciate and welcome you into that moment, to use your power to face our issues, to tabernacle with you in such a way where we become more and more like you. God, we pray, we beg and plead, Lord God, that you be the one who continues to move us through this season. We ask right now, Lord God, in this space and in this period of COVID, this period of isolation, that you continue to remind us that we are still in communion and in community with you. We need you, Lord God, to be the one who is our voice, to be the one who is our wisdom, our sensibility, to be the one who helps us to make sense of life and all of its many challenges. God, we ask that you go ahead of us now. We ask that you continue to do the things that you do. Heal, strengthen, and renew, and help us, Father, to live in this moment with power just for you. We ask and beg that you do just that as we continue to seek you with all of our heart. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Listen, don't stop praying. As you wrestle with God in this occasion, remember that you are inviting God in the process of facing your aloneness knowing that you got to defy the heart's trickery, defy hurtful behavior, and defy and step into the holy becoming that God wants to give you. Don't stop praying. I'm going to pray for you. I'm asking you, please pray for me, and let's watch our God change everything around us. God bless you and God bless you.
I know it seemed like the devil. Seemed like he's winning sometimes. But I came here to let you know that the devil is a God is true. God said, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Come on. Look at your neighbor and say, go get your armor.
Go get your armor and fight the fight. Go get your helmet, get your sword, and get your shield.
It's time to stand.
Stand and do God's will.
Everything.
Everything is gonna be okay.
Yeah.
Look out, the enemy is on his way.
Watch out now. Come on.
With God on my side.
With God. Everything. I came to tell you. You don't have nothing to worry about. Just keep your faith in the master. I need a witness. Marissa. Philip.
Everything is gonna be alright. Though your day seems dark as night. Satan's strong, but God is stronger. So keep the faith and you gotta keep pressing on.